Right guys, welcome back to another video on the channel, and today I'm going to be talking about the second leg of the UEFA Champions League quarterfinal. I did a video last week talking about the first leg, previewing and give predictions on it, and today I'm doing the same but for the second leg. And so we'll start off with the games that are happening tonight. The first one, and probably the big one of the night, I believe it is Napoli hosting AC Milan at the Diego Maradona Stadium in Naples. So obviously there is news that Victor Osimhen, the Napoli center forward, will be available for Napoli, and that's a huge plus for Napoli. But obviously the last time these two teams played at Naples, Milan won 4-0. Obviously different circumstances, the league, and probably Milan kind of rested a few Napoli probably have rested a few players, so I do think this game will be a lot more close, just like the first leg where it was only 1-0. So I do think that this game is going to be really, very close, and yeah, it could go either way. Even though Milan have the advantage, what would the mindset, what would be the start, the starting plan for Milan in this game? They have a one-goal lead, but if Napoli score within the first 5-10 minutes, you know, it's basically the plan of maybe sitting back and protect the 1-0 lead will not be sufficient enough. So I do think Milan probably have to be a little bit more direct early on in the game in order to insert some sort of dominance, because I think if Napoli were to take, you know, the early momentum and score a goal within the first 5-10 minutes, I think Napoli could end up beating Milan quite comfortably. Obviously, I'm probably expecting Milan to be a little bit more attacking. I believe Kim Min-jae, one of the center backs for Napoli, is suspended, I'm not sure. And that probably could be a big bonus for Milan if they were to do a lot of attacking work, which I believe they have to in this game, because if they're just going to sit back, I think Napoli wins this, you know, 2-3-4-0, you know, reverse the scoreline from, you know, a few weeks ago. And obviously both of these teams, I believe, did not win this past weekend, so both teams are not in a good sort of run of form, but obviously Milan have the advantage, and maybe with the heritage of Milan could pull them through. How do I see this game going? I do think Milan will try to insert some dominance. And I think I'll go for a draw in this game. I do think this will be very close. Look, I could be wrong. I could see Napoli winning this 3-4-0. But I do have some belief in this Napoli team. Napoli are prone to really go at this game, and I do expect Napoli to be more of the front foot, but Milan to really, really try to put in a lot of the dominance as well and really, really counter Napoli in this game. So I'm going for a draw, but I can see Napoli winning this. So that's mainly because I have Milan going to the Champions League final, but you know, if they do make it to the Champions League final, or at least the semi-final, you know, they have to get past Napoli, who I think every single person has Napoli going to the final. And for me, I kind of have to back my early prediction of Milan making it to the final. So I kind of have to back Milan. And so far, it has worked out well. So I'm going for a draw, 1-1. But I can easily see Napoli, you know, crushing Milan if they really, really put in the dominance in the first 5-10 minutes. Second game of tonight, it is Chelsea at Stamford Bridge taking on Real Madrid. Real Madrid have a 2-goal lead in this game. And let me be honest, I know there might be all the magical UCL Knights at the Bridge. Look, this is a different Chelsea. This is under Frank Lampard. This is not Tuchel. This is not Di Matteo. At least Di Matteo had something about him in terms of a managerial or coaching ability, whereas Lampard doesn't really have any, you know. And you kind of see it, 3 games against what? Wolves, Brighton, and Real Madrid. Chelsea only scored 1 goal in those 3 games and conceded 5 or something like that. So I just do not see Chelsea really getting into this game. Obviously, if they do get an early goal, you know, maybe something can happen. But I just feel like the quality of Real Madrid, even if Real Madrid will not be at the A game, I just think that this two-goal lead that Madrid have, I think it already killed the tie for Chelsea, even if Chelsea fans want to believe that they can do it. Look, if Chelsea do it, then fair play, but I do not see Chelsea getting past a Man City or even a Bayern if they were to make the semi-final. So I'm going for a 1-0 win for Real Madrid, maybe an early goal for Real Madrid, and it probably just kills the game off, because I just don't think Chelsea are that innovative or creative. And under the stewardship of Lampard, I just do not see a comeback from Chelsea. And then tomorrow's games, obviously we'll talk about the big one, but let's start off with Internazionale, Inter Milan taking on Benfica. And surprisingly, Inter have a 2-goal lead. I think I predicted a 2-0 Benfica win. I thought Benfica have some sort of momentum, and I just realized they're not really in a good run of form. Inter are in a decent-ish amount of form, but they do have a 2-goal lead compared to their, you know, arch rivals Milan having only a 1-0 lead against Napoli. This 2-0 lead that Inter have is very, very crucial, and that home game at the San Siro, I think, can be rocking, because it has that feel of a Milanese or a Milan team making the semifinal. And let's say if Milan, AC Milan, make the semifinal, I think there will be a huge, huge support for Inter Milan to really, you know, put in the motivation. Because could you imagine if Milan and Inter Milan meet in the semifinal? That would be amazing. And maybe that might add some motivation. So I think regardless of that, do I think Benfica have a chance? I do believe so. This is a lot more closer than, let's say, the other games may have, like the Real Madrid or Chelsea, or when we talk about later, Bayern or Man City. So do I think that there's going to be a dramatic story in this game, a dramatic comeback or something like that? I personally could see it, but I'm holding it out. I just think that Inter will just about squeak past. I think it will be kind of close. I am actually going for a 2-1 win for Benfica, but the aggregate score will be 3-2 for Inter. So I see Inter Milan making it to the semifinals with AC Milan and having a Milan derby in the semifinal. But I could be wrong. I could definitely see Benfica really, really trying it out and really putting a lot of pressure on Inter if Inter do not have that sort of capability of pushing forward and winning games. And then the final quarterfinal is Bayern Munich taking on Manchester City. 3-0 lead for Man City. I think I predicted a 1 or 2-0 win for Man City. And Man City totally outplayed Bayern in that game. And there's a lot of unrest in that Bayern camp. Obviously, there was news about Sadio Mane punching Leroy Sané, a former Man City player. A former Liverpool player punching a former Man City player. So it's not looking good at Bayern at the moment. I just think Man City, look, do people think that there's going to be any glimmer of hope for Bayern? I just don't think so. I do not see Pep Guardiola overthinking it at this, you know, with this 3-0 lead, which is the biggest lead that Man City have in a Champions League, you know, second leg going into it. I just do not see Man City bottling it, just like how I see Real Madrid not bottling it against Chelsea. So I'm just going to say that Man City, maybe they'll lose, but it's not going to be enough for Bayern to beat them over the course of this match. So I'm going for a 2-0 Man City win. So I'm actually going to say 5-0 on aggregate for Manchester City. But I could be totally wrong and Bayern win like 1 or 2-0, but I'm just going to say I don't think Bayern will have enough in terms of the number of goals for them to really do it. Just because I just do not see Man City just like capitulating, because that would be a disaster for them. And I think if they were to capitulate and not make it into the semifinal, I think that would massively affect their league form. Probably positively, who knows. And so the teams I have going to the semifinal are actually the teams that have the lead right now. So both Milan clubs, AC Milan and Inter Milan, alongside Man City and Real Madrid. So we'll have to wait and see how the semifinal looks and how it plays out in these games tonight and tomorrow night. And I'll see you guys in the next one.